Hello everyone, welcome to the Well of Curiosity and to Natural Disasters 101. Last time we examined the destructive capabilities of volcanic eruptions. Now we move on to another type of disaster from beneath the ground, earthquakes. The ground beneath our feet may feel solid, but our Earth is capable of shaking so violently that buildings collapse, rents open up in the surface, and mountainsides tumble down. This shaking event is known as an earthquake, the vibration of rocks caused by the sudden release of energy in the Earth's interior, which can cause violent movement at the surface, lasting from a few seconds to several minutes. Our planet is alive with earthquakes. Technically, they can occur anywhere, but will most frequently occur in relatively narrow zones near the active boundaries of tectonic plates. For example, most large earthquakes will occur around the edges of the Pacific Ocean, in the notorious Ring of Fire. Although some earthquakes can be caused by volcanic or even human activity, most are due to the movement of the Earth's tectonic plates. In the regions close to plate boundaries, as the plates move in different directions, the rocks are squeezed and stretched like a spring. Near the surface, the stress of this squeezing and stretching action can cause the rocks to eventually break along faults. If this break occurs suddenly, then the rocks snap, like a piece of elastic, releasing multiple waves of energy and generating the violent vibrations of an earthquake that shakes the ground and displaces areas of land horizontally or vertically. The waves of an earthquake have distinctive patterns and can be split into two categories, body waves and surface waves. Body waves can travel through the body of the Earth and consist of primary waves, or P waves, which travel faster and have a back and forth motion like a vibrating spring, and secondary waves, or S waves, which travel slower and have a more snake-like motion. Surface waves travel slower than body waves and spread across the Earth's surface. Love waves produce a side-to-side vibration, whereas Raleigh waves move with an up-and-down rolling motion not too dissimilar to ocean waves. It's these surface waves that typically deal the most destruction. Earthquakes can wreak havoc on a vast scale. The shaking caused during even a moderate earthquake can be enough to topple freestanding structures and buildings. Damage to gas pipes, oil installations, and electrical cables can cause the spread of fires throughout a town or city. If a large earthquake occurs underwater, it can displace huge volumes of water, creating a tsunami. More on that in another video. Earthquakes that take place in mountainous regions can destabilize hill slopes, causing rockfalls and landslides. These landslides may then block rivers, causing widespread flooding. The very ground may be altered in a process called soil liquefaction. In areas where the ground is saturated with water, the shaking can force the water out of pore spaces, turning the ground into a liquid. This can cause mud and sand to erupt from the ground and allow objects at the surface to sink down. A new hazard presented itself in 2011, when an earthquake in Japan damaged a nuclear power plant in Fukushima. Partial core meltdown and hydrogen explosions led to leaks of radioactive material into the surrounding environment, adding yet another layer of danger to this type of natural disaster. For hundreds of years, scientists have used delicate instruments called seismometers to measure vibrations during an earthquake. The recording part is free to move with the Earth, while the rest of it is firmly anchored and remains stationary. Traditional models used a pen to trace waves onto a rotating drum, but modern instruments can record the vibrations electronically. The intensity of shaking is indicated using a scale. For many years, this was the Richter scale, but it has been replaced with the similar, but more accurate and reliable, moment magnitude scale. This scale can be interpreted in terms of the amount of movement that has occurred in the ground multiplied by the size of the fault, estimating the energy released at the source. The highest magnitude earthquakes assigned so far are between 9 and 10, but that is a limitation of the Earth, not in the scale itself. Now that we have had an overview of earthquakes, let's look at a particular example. In May 2008, a magnitude 7.9 earthquake struck eastern Sichuan in China. It was one of the worst earthquakes to hit China in over 30 years. It was created when a 200-kilometer long fault in the Longmenshan Mountains, near the boundary between the Indian and Asian tectonic plates, suddenly slipped between 2 and 9 meters. The tremors that were unleashed were felt throughout much of China, as well as other countries like Bangladesh, Thailand, and Vietnam. More than 5 million buildings collapsed, with landslides and rockfalls blocking roads and railway lines. Sadly, over 70,000 people lost their lives, with hundreds of thousands injured and tens of millions displaced from their homes. Hopefully, this video has been useful in giving an insight into earthquakes. We will continue to explore the natural disasters that our Earth can unleash in future episodes, but for now, stay curious and I'll see you next time.